Just want to show you a moment that happened yesterday in the Oval Office. President Trump was trying to prove that Alabama was in harm's way, that Hurricane Dorian was heading to Alabama. So he held this event in the Oval Office, which shows the official National Weather Service projection. And I don't know if you, right there, perhaps you can see with the untrained eye that someone has drawn in black magic marker Alabama. Because since the projection didn't really include Alabama, the president wanted to make his point, and so someone just drew it on there. What is your reaction to that?
I'm really worried about it. I feel sorry for the president. And that is not the way we should feel about the most powerful figure in this country, somebody on whose wisdom and judgment our lives literally depend. I don't know if he felt it necessary to pull out a Sharpie and change the map. I don't know if it was one of his aides believed they had to do that in order to protect his ego. No matter how you cut it, this is an unbelievably sad state of affairs for our country. If our presidency is not in good shape, then our country is not in good shape. And on one level, it's laughable. On another, it is exactly why we've got to do something different. And by the way, I also think it's why you're seeing a lot of independents and people who have voted Republican over the years saying, you know what, this has become something we've all got to pull together and create an alternative to, because we just, as a country, cannot go on with these. This is humiliating. This is an embarrassing moment for our country, and we seem to see a new national embarrassment every day.
And so when you say you feel sad for the president, or you feel sad for the country, or
both.
What?
Both. Look, when the presidency has been reduced to this, all of us are diminished, because the presidency is supposed to be something we all look up to, even when we disagree with the president. It's not supposed to be a disagreement over, it's not even a disagreement. What we're seeing there is literally pathetic. It makes you feel a kind of pity for everybody involved. And that's not how I want to feel about the president, whether it's from my party or the other one.
President Trump doesn't believe in climate change. I mean, he's on the record saying weather changes, he doesn't believe in it. So what he is focused on is building the wall,
right?
Building his promised wall. And he is going to be basically siphoning off some military construction funds in order to build the wall, something to the tune of like $3.6 billion. So now the Pentagon has come out with what will be lost with that. So I'll just read it to you. This is from the New York Times. The Pentagon plans to divert funds from military construction projects in nearly half of the 50 states, three territories, and 19 countries. The cuts involve projects such as rifle ranges, aircraft simulators, hangars, port repairs, and a cyber operations center in Virginia, with the biggest impact in Puerto Rico, Guam, New York, and New Mexico. So, listen, we all know that there's a lot of pork in military budgets. Can't some of those things be done away with? Is that a big loss to be losing money from those projects?
Yeah, let's look at our priorities. Look, a cyber operations center sounds to me like exactly the sort of thing we need more of in the 21st century, because we know 21st century security threats include things like cyber threats, as well as things like dealing with climate security. And here you have a president focused on what amounts to a 17th century security solution, which is putting up a wall, at a moment when the biggest threats to this country aren't things that are stopped by walls. They're things like hurricanes and cyber attacks, in addition to stateless terrorism and all the other things that our country is up against. I would rather have the rifle ranges, the hangars, and the cyber operations center, because that's involved in keeping America safe. There's no question that the Pentagon budget can be bloated, but it's also extremely important that we have the best equipped military in the world. And when I was in the military, I knew that I had the advantage of the resources that this country puts into our national defense. The idea that you would divert that you would gut that at a time like this, and especially take it out of things that are a lot more relevant to keeping us safe today than putting up this wall, shows you just how upside down and, frankly, just how antique the president's security priorities really are.